In this comparative analysis, I will be talking about the narrative arcs, as well as the similarities and differences between two social thriller films, Us, a 2019 American film directed by Jordan Peele, and Parasite, a 2019 South Korean film directed by Bong Joon-ho. The social thriller genre is known for having a combination of horror and satire aspects that exaggerate situations to bring light to social issues. Both films Us and Parasite utilize this genre to highlight class struggles. There is similar symbolism in these two films, but the portrayal of class struggles is what differentiates them. To begin, I will discuss the different geographical and social contexts of Parasite and Us. The film Us starts off in the year 1986 in Santa Cruz, California. The year 1986 is emphasized by pop culture references throughout the film, such as the main character Adelaide wearing a Michael Jackson shirt as a kid, and VHS tapes of 80s films. The rest of the film, however, takes place in modern-day Santa Cruz, following the lives of a wealthy upper-middle-class family, the Wilsons. Us received critical acclaim and was the biggest opening at the box office for an original horror movie.
The Wilsons go on a summer trip to their Santa Cruz vacation home.
They hope to have a fun time, but Adelaide starts having a bad feeling about being there. Soon, things do turn awry, and the Wilsons' doppelgangers begin terrorizing them and try to murder them. They find out that everyone in America has a doppelganger, known as the Tethered, who are killing their real-life counterparts to form a human chain as an act of revenge and protest. Parasite, however, follows the lives of a lower-class family, the Kims, living in South Korea. The Kims live in a semi-basement apartment, don't have steady jobs, and struggle to get by. The Parks, on the other hand, are an uber-wealthy family living in an extremely nice house.
Kim Ki-woo is offered a job being a tutor for the Parks, and then later recommends his sister to the family to be an art tutor.
This cycle continues until all the members of the Kim family are working at the Parks house. The film eventually won an Academy Award for Best Picture, a first for a film not in the English language. Both Parasite and Us have heavily exaggerated situations.
People's doppelgangers killing their real-life counterparts, and a poor family working undercover at a rich family's house.
According to Andrew Chow, both Parasite and Us focus on the clash between two mirrored families of four, one privileged and one oppressed.
They sow a contrast between large airy houses and seedy underground spaces, and are informed by house invasion tropes and horror genre frameworks. There is a stark distinction between the two opposing sides in these films.
For instance, the places they live in, their jobs, and the way they interact with their family. However, the separation of the poor and the rich in both films is symbolized by the underground.
In Us, there are many forgotten underground tunnels throughout the United States that house the Tethered. In Parasite, the Kims live in a semi-basement apartment.
And Gunse, a person hiding from debt collectors, lives in a forgotten bunker in the basement of the Parks house. The Tethered, Kims, and Gunse literally live underground.
This figuratively represents their lower class status compared to the wealthy in the respective films. This is also emphasized through the use of lighting and cinematography.
The tunnels in Us have a very dim lighting and an eerie atmosphere. The semi-basement apartment in Parasite has an almost dilapidated look to it, and the bunker also has an eerie atmosphere, with the dark green lighting rather than the bright lights of the Parks house. In Us, Red, Adelaide's doppelganger, talks about how the Tethered was a botched government experiment to control the doppelganger's real-life counterparts.
They created the Tethered so they could use them to control the ones above. Like puppets. But they failed.
It is implied that whoever was in charge of the Tethered abandoned and forgot about them, in hopes that the problem would solve on its own.
This is similar to how, at the end of Parasite, when Gunse leaves the bunker and causes havoc at a birthday party, Dong-ik, father of the Park family, attempts to leave the party without helping the Kim family, whose daughter had just been murdered.
The Park family only cared about themselves and did nothing to help the Kims. Another similarity in Parasite and Us is how the two opposing sides impact each other in a symbiotic relationship. For example, until the Kims start working for the Parks, they have unstable jobs and struggle to make ends meet. When they are hired by the Parks, the Kims have money and take advantage of the Parks' lush resources.
The Kims perform tasks that the Parks can't do on their own, providing transportation, cleaning dishes, making food, etc. Before the Tethered escape the tunnels in Us, they do almost the exact same actions as their real-life counterparts.
For instance, the Wilsons have kids, go on carnival rides, and eat food.
But this is torture to the Tethered.
When Red was giving birth, she had to perform a C-section on herself since there were no doctors around like with Adelaide. The Tethered don't have actual carnival rides, so they are stuck in rooms having to pretend they are on one. And since they don't have actual food in the tunnels, when the real-life counterparts are eating food, the Tethered have to eat raw rabbits. While the people above are living the good lives, the tethered are stuck underground with a miserable life. Red speaks to Adelaide about how the people above ground are so privileged to do simple things like seeing the sky, sleeping on a nice bed, and getting presents. The whole time, the people above ground are oblivious to the fact that they have doppelgangers living underground. Similar to how in Parasite, the Parks have no idea of the bunker in the basement and the fact that Gunse lives in it. None of the tethered can actually speak, except for Red, who was the person living above ground originally before Adelaide stole her life. This represents how the tethered have no privilege and don't have access to the knowledge and education that the people above ground have. Red has a voice because she had some privilege and education before Adelaide stole her life.
This is similar to how, in Parasite, the Kims were able to live in the lavish park house until they were caught and forced to move back to their semi-basement home. We can also see how the poor is treated as a joke to the Park family.
The members of the Park family continue to talk about how the Kim family smells bad.
And during a sex scene, they do a role play pretending they are poor, selling drugs and wearing cheap underwear.
The events in both Parasite and Us lead to an act of violence that is inevitable. In Parasite, the infiltration of the Park House by the Kims and their unwillingness to help Gunse and his wife Moon Gwang leads to Gunse's uprising and massacre of people at the birthday party, and the death of Ki Jung, the daughter of the Kim family. In Us, Adelaide's theft of Red's life leads to a fight in the tunnels in which Adelaide kills Red, keeping her place as the sole person of the two who gets to live above ground. Because of these acts of violence, there is no happy ending in these two films. This emphasizes that when a person tries to play with the system, conflict is bound to happen. Because Adelaide stole Red's life, Red started an uprising to take over America in an act of revenge. Because the Kims didn't help Gunse and Moon Gwang, Gunse massacred the people of the birthday party and Ki Jung died. The characters in the films lose because of a ripple effect caused by one person. In conclusion, we can see from the films that they aren't explicitly political. None of the villains in the story in this case, the rich, have a stated political party they belong to. The rich in these films are defined by their wealth, not by their beliefs. The films also show how the main factor in class struggles isn't necessarily caused by the rich individuals themselves, but by the toxicity of the system. Us represented this in a very metaphorical way. The tethered could represent any social ill,
while Parasite critiqued class struggles in a literal way, showing a battle between the poor and the rich.